Shamima Begum, the British schoolgirl who left the UK to join so-called Islamic State in Syria, aged 15, is to lose her UK citizenship. In a statement, the Home Secretary explained the moves in order to protect the country. Her family has reacted by saying they're disappointed with the decision and are considering all legal avenues to challenge it. Well, Nikita Malik is director at the Centre on Radicalisation and Terrorism at the right-wing think tank, the Henry Jackson Society.
The decision that's been made to strip Shamima Begum of her citizenship is one of many tools in the government's legal toolkit when it responds to individuals who pose a risk or a danger to our country. Another mechanism that could have been used was a temporary exclusion order, which I believe lasts for 1 year and also doesn't allow an individual to come back to the UK. But so from a legal and a technical perspective, it is possible to do. It has been done in the past. It was done 33 times, I believe, in 2015 against other individuals who posed a risk to the United Kingdom. So from that standpoint, it is a stance that the Home Secretary has chosen to take. Having said that, from a kind of a moral perspective, we really need to be thinking about a few different issues here, which are complicating many factors. I am a counterterrorism specialist. I've focused on women and children for many years. I think that Shamima Begum is due appropriate punishment. She should be tried in court and evidence should be presented of her crimes. But by stripping her of her citizenship, we are essentially giving the responsibility of trying her to another country, whether that's Bangladesh or Iraq or Syria. And we cannot continue to export individuals who grew up in Britain and make them the responsibility of other countries, whether it's the, ISIS beatles, those jihadist fighters who there was a legal battle between the US and the UK on this. And now the US has taken responsibility. We have to take responsibility for these individuals and by all means give them a heavy punishment for the crimes they have committed. But by stripping her of her citizenship, we have essentially abdicated that responsibility, which I don't think is a good thing that we have done.
Yes, and there have also been people who are foreign nationals living in Britain that we have wanted to get rid of. Now, if other countries did the same, they could simply strip them of citizenship and we'd be stuck.
Exactly. And in fact, there have been instances where we have been stuck because a case has been made by these individuals that sending them to a country like Jordan, for example, would mean, or Syria would mean that they are tortured for information. And we've only managed to send these individuals back because of assurances from these governments that they won't. So this is a very emotive issue, but actually it's quite a technical one. We are a country that operates with many international players. We have legal obligations to them. We have legal obligations to our citizens. By all means, let us protect our citizens, put the highest amount of security possible, put the highest punishments possible, reintroduce the treason laws that we've had, the ancient laws, punish these individuals for a very long time, monitor them, but don't leave them, say, in a refugee camp where her child as well, no one knows what kind of nationality this child has, because I'm not a lawyer, I can't really say, but, he has potentially three nationalities. The best way we can monitor this individual and ensure that they don't grow up to become an ISIS cub, which was precisely what she signed up for when she signed up to this organization, it was to be a mother and a wife and a creator of the next generation of soldiers. Let's ensure that doesn't happen. And the only way to do that is by keeping a close eye and keeping him away from a radicalizing influence like the Islamic State or like her.
And you mentioned the threat she might pose if she came back here. You know, from what you've heard from her, she doesn't seem to regret very much. Do you think she does pose a big threat?
Yes, I think this is due to, again, crime. I think there are repercussions for crime. Terrorism is one of the biggest criminal offences. She doesn't show regret or remorse. It wasn't like 2 or 3 years ago, and we don't know the full story, but she wasn't trying to escape and saying that she regretted it and wanted to come back to the UK. And her story is not an extraordinary one, even though we have given her so much media attention. There are many British women just like her who have actually come back to the UK with their kids. I've outlined two of these cases in a report I released today. They had temporary exclusion orders, but they came back and presented themselves to authorities in the UK. There are also, as we've seen, many of these women of the Islamic State coming out now from originally the US saying they want to go back. And this case is not unique. What we need are sufficient protocols to assess evidence, to ensure that punishment is given. And if she doesn't show regret or remorse, then of course she presents a potential risk. And by stripping her of citizenship, we're giving credence to her grievance now and potentially making a martyr out of her, which is precisely what a lot of these extremist groups want to have happened.
Nikita Malik there from the Henry Jackson Society.
News Drive on BBC Radio Scotland.
The headlines: three MPs have left the Conservative Party.